In this video, we will look at how to find and use Artnet. From the library's homepage, you'll want to click on the databases link in the top menu. This will take you to our databases page, which allows you to find any of our databases in two different ways. First, here you'll see we have them all sorted by subject, and you could find Artnet under Art History and Fine Arts, Illustration, Photography. But you can also click on Databases A to Z list, and scroll through the A's until you reach Artnet. As you'll see, we have two different Artnet databases, the Fine Art and Design one and the Decorative Art one. If you click on the plus sign, you'll see that this tells you that you need to ask the library by clicking on this link to request the password. Let's take a look at the database itself. If I click on this link, I'll be taken to Artnet. So, as you can see, there are two different databases. The first one allows you to research the price of decorative art or antiques, and the second one allows you to research the price of fine art and design. Let's look at fine art and design by clicking Use the Database. You'll see that you're immediately taken to a search box, and you're immediately in fine art and design, but if you want to switch to decorative art, you can do that by clicking this tab. Now, you'll see that you have basically a form you can fill out with the information you have about the item, artist, whatever you are researching. So first up is the artist, and you can decide whether or not you want to include artistic collaborations, so when maybe there are multiple artists listed, and also whether or not you want to include modifiers, such as when it's attributed to that person. If you would like, you can also specify what auction house you're interested in researching at. Next up, you'll see that you can specify what types of art you're interested in. You can say you're all interested in all fine art and design, or you can specify that you're only interested in paintings, for example, photographs, sculpture, etc. If you know more details about the work, that will help you to narrow your results. And basically what you always want to do is try to narrow your results so that you're not searching through a bunch of results that aren't what you're looking for. So if you know anything else about a specific item that you're hoping to find, you can enter that information here. Sale date and sale location will allow you to specify down to a particular sale if you are looking at that. And you can also specify a price range or estimate price range if you're interested in basing your search on those price elements. Now, if you see this, you can check the number of results. And we also see that there's a help feature here, as there is next to many of these. So if you click on the check the number of results, that's going to tell you what number of results you're going to get before you've actually run the search. And that's helpful because if it's going to be a really large number above 100, you may well want to refine your search criteria. And when they say refine your search criteria, that basically means that you want to add additional modifiers, additional pieces of information. Maybe if you know the artist, you would also say what medium of their work you're interested in, those sorts of things. Next, you're going to specify how you want to view your results. So you can say that you want sale date, but you can also pick other things, like maybe you want to know when the work was created and have that be the main way that the results are sorted, or maybe you want the price to be how the results are sorted. You can also say that you want to exclude results without an image, exclude bought in lots, or show only items that are bought in lots. Now, clicking this will find the first 100 results for the search that you've constructed. Let's try running a search. So we'll use their example, Charles Eames. And you'll see that it's going to pop up with some suggestions. So I can pick one of these if I would like, and you'll see that one of the options is Charles and Ray Eames, or you can limit to just Charles Eames. So let's pick this, and I am going to just see how many results that would lead to using the check number of results item. So you'll see this is going to be 940 results. So I can decide whether or not that's a number that I'm comfortable with, and maybe I want to add some additional modifications. Maybe I'm only interested in recent sales, for example. So I could come up here, and I click the little icon for calendar, and maybe I would like to know September 2019 to September 2020, what was the sale like? So I'm going to jump back and say from September 1st, 2019 to the 1st of 2020. And if I check the number of results again, that's going to give me 49 results. So I can click View First 100 Results in order to see what that looks like. Now, from here, you'll see you have a bunch of options. You can select all, and then once you've selected things, you can print, export to PDF, or save the selected lots. That allows you to refer back to the information without having to continually rerun the searches, which is good from an efficiency standpoint. And you'll see that you get a little bit of a record for each of the results on this page. It's going to show you a small picture, often though not always, and then some brief information about the item. If you want the full details, however, you will need to click. So let's click on full details here. And you'll see that, again, I have the image a little bit larger. And I have a much more lengthy description of the item and any sales, other information like that, estimated price, final price, those sorts of pieces of information. If I want to go back to the results screen, I can do that here by clicking this link. And again, I would just pick whichever items are of interest for more information. And you'll see for some things, there may not be an image available. As you may recall, that was one of the search terms we could have limited by. We could have said we only want ones with the image available, potentially. So that's a brief overview on how to use Artnet's basic features. I hope you'll find that useful as you're going through your project. If you have questions on this or anything else, please ask the library.